ourselves in a world where energy was becoming scarce, out of reach. Light, which we had often taken for granted, was slowly disappearing. A group of scientists developed a program that few were aware of. They were young, ambitious, and creative, and their project was founded on a radical discovery. Certain individuals had the ability to produce an intense light emanation, but this light could only be extracted under specific, sometimes hazardous conditions. We were a select few, chosen for our body's capacity to resist the harsh experiments that we would have to undergo. To the human eye, these emanations were nothing more than a glow, an aura surrounding our bodies. But when properly extracted, they would suffice to produce an abundance of luminous energy. A dozen of us were examined, used, and reused by these faceless, nameless scientists. They knew everything about every single one of us, past, present, mental, and physiological, but we knew nothing about them.
Patient O and A, I think she's the one. 425 lumens of light emanation, that's more than I've ever seen. If we push her to the extreme, we could get another 5 years out of her and even perhaps attack like 650 lumens. Look at this graph. This is a significantly high rate of light concentration and it's all located in her hair. I mean, we can't miss this chance.
She's so young. How would she react to the treatment?
We don't have time for doubt. The energy crisis committee has been on our back for a while now and we haven't shown any results. They're getting anxious. They need this light. And we need this light too.
Your participation in this research is entirely voluntary. It is your choice whether to participate or not. Whether you choose to participate or not, all the services you receive at this clinic will continue and nothing will change. If you choose not to participate in this research project, you will be offered the treatment that is routinely offered in this facility. You may change your mind and stop participating even if you previously agreed.
Do you agree to the following terms?
Yes.
Please sign here.
Welcome, patient O1A. You are now an official patient of the medical research facility.
Forearm, knees, shoulder, hand. And so the treatment began. She found herself completely disconnected from the outside world. No way for people to contact her. No way for her to contact other people. She was alone. Since she had become patient O1A, and the physical demands of the experiments were draining her of the little energy she had left. Her body was increasingly weakened by the treatment. lost their glisten. Her face had lost its cherubic glow. She had lost her mind. It was time. On day 14, patient O1A had generated all the luminous emanations her body contained. The extraction process had drained her of her vital energy. Nothing was left, and there was nothing more to expect. She was the first, and I was the next.